This work, of course, is in collaboration with Louisiana State University, and we are doing the electrochemical characterization at Texas A&M, or corrosion characterization, and here in Louisiana State, they are doing the synthesis. So it's a very very good, very integral project, and it's characterizing and understanding these self-healing microcapsules in terms of corrosion. Before going into the details of the self-healing and the microcapsule, I think this diagram illustrates very well what it means corrosion in rebar reinforced structure. So this rebar, we call it the working electrode in corrosion, or the thing that is going to corrode. And the concrete, we call it electrolyte. Once we have these both together, we have a composite, or we have a material that comprises this working and the electrolyte. And the important part in corrosion is the interface, is where this electrolyte and the rebar meets. And of course, that if you put this in an environment, you form an electrochemical cell. And this diagram illustrates the cumulative damage evolution of the rebar. And this is very important because I think I named several times that this rebar is in a passive state. It forms an oxide layer that is stable, that is homogeneous. But once the corrosion precursors, which is water, oxygen, and chloride, are going and migrate within this concrete structure, it will start to influence this passive layer. So whatever you hear about the chloride threshold is because you are break down this passive layer. And chloride is not directly in the corrosion reactions, but oxygen and iron is. So chloride, what it's gonna do is induce the breakdown of the passive layer going into the stage one, we call it the initiation stage, because it's an intact passive stage, and to the activation and propagation stage, which is the corrosion. Again, chloride is gonna break down this passive layer, and it's gonna start to activate the corrosion reactions, which you see, instead of forming this beautiful passive layer, which everybody sees that is very homogeneous, they're gonna form a new, very high volume passive layer or corrosion product that will start to cause internal stresses in the concrete. And of course, you're gonna start to form cracks and spouts and lead to the fact that you have different stresses that you didn't calculate from the beginning. So what if we have something in the concrete that delays this stage or makes it longer? So that's why we are using one of the basic concepts in corrosion is inhibitors. These inhibitors, what if, because we just tackle or attack these corrosion precursors, so we can have an effect on this, this, or this. So what we are putting is chloride or inhibitors in the concrete in a way that we need to capture, trap, or avoid these three precursors of corrosion in the concrete to start this reaction to happen. So these three stages are important to define in corrosion, but we're gonna be focused on stage one in a way that if we add these inhibitors, we are gonna be able to, again, trap or avoid this chloride effect in the concrete structure. So what we are doing now is to add a component in a very homogeneous distributed way that allows us to make these precursors either to react or to trap. So the corrosion inhibitor mechanism with microcapsules increases the stage one to avoid any corrosion damage in the rebar. So that's what the effect of the principle does. So in terms of microcapsules, have been utilized to deliver method for self-healing concept. The self-healing means that when you have these corrosion precursors going into the concrete, when these microcapsules release something because of corrosion precursors will go and touch these entities, will release something that is gonna be beneficial. So that's why it's the self-healing effect, which right now is not only used only in concrete, but also in coatings, which makes the healing effect be in effect once something is attacking the structure that originally is formed. So also the microcapsules are very easy to fabricate, so there are the versatility, and also makes this very cost-effective way of producing concrete for integrity. And of course that we have different chemicals, and in corrosion there are some inhibitors that are detrimental. So it's important when you have an inhibitor to select the best, not only chemical, but the best concentration to make the effect of the inhibitor in the concrete. So this is an illustration of the mechanism of the self-healing or the microcapsules. You see this is the cement. This is, well, the cement has some discontinuities, and these are the microcapsules. So when you have water uptake or electrolyte uptakes the concrete and touches these microcapsules, what happens is that absorption and a chemical release of these form capsules will have a release of chemical. This chemical will be released in the mass of the concrete, and it's going to start to form layers, or it's going to start to form sections or distribution of chemicals. These chemicals will trap any precursor of corrosion and then avoid the influence of that breakdown of the passive layer. So again, once you touch with the electrolyte, these microcapsules, it's going to be a release and a formation of a chemical that is able to inhibit the precorrosion precursors. So these principles, this is the principle of extending the stage one of by adding these microcapsules in the concrete structure. So the objectives of this project is to study the performance of these entities in the concrete mass as a corrosion inhibitor, going into the details of the concentration, because again, every single inhibitor has a normal distribution where you maximize the effect based on the fact of that concentration. So if you add more, maybe you will start to have a detrimental effect, or if you don't have enough, then you don't have the effect or the reaction that you want to induce in terms of corrosion control. Of course, when we do this, we need a test that is reliable and tell us if, in terms of corrosion, it gives us the best concentration and the best microcapsule chemicals to see if these are a good effect in terms of corrosion. And of course, that the test sometimes in concrete, and I've been doing these tests for many, many years, and concrete is one of the most difficult ones, because in order to make it corrode, you need to wait years. So no one is going to wait years nowadays to corrode rebar, but this is the Murphy's law. In the lab, they don't corrode. In the field, they corrode. So we need to combine this Murphy's law with real conditions. So what we are doing also is to have a test that is not only reliable but fast. So that's what we are doing also in this project. So materials and methods, again, is the preparation which it's been held in Louisiana State. So the process is a polymerization based on water in oil suspension, reaction of polyurea and formaldehyde, and then you see the micro, very nice shape. It's a very nice, I love this picture, by the way, because the shape and the form. And this is, in terms of corrosion, most ideal shape form, because it's a spheric way. So you have a very nice surface condition for the water when it uptakes. It touches all the surface of the microcapsules. So this is the way to do the microcapsule, the synthesis. And these are the composition, the experimental metrics that we start to develop in order to see the best and the most suitable composition in terms of the chemicals that we are using for these microcapsules. And also, of course, that we need to have concrete properties that all, because of the fact that you have these additions of the concrete, should have a very similar properties of the concrete in terms of mechanical aspects and the either compressive and the surface resistivity. We follow that standards, and we follow that the properties are mimic the concrete characteristics that we need. And also in terms of corrosion, we try to do a technique that is able not only doing in the lab, but the technique that we are using, you can put it in the field. In the field means that you need to touch a rebar, even you don't need to drill, you just need to touch a little, one pinpoint of the rebar, one touch of the rebar, and then we can just explore whatever is inside of the concrete. So this is an electrochemical technique that is able to see what is the corrosion status or conditions of the rebar. So we use DC method and also AC method, which is new and is non-destructive evaluation. So in terms of corrosion characterization, which I'm going to cover a little bit more rather than the synthesis, is the open circuit potential. I think that in civil engineering, everybody just follows the open circuit. And I think that I'm starting to do a campaign to tell civil engineering that potential is a thermodynamic magnitude. Thermodynamics is feasibility. Kinetics is what tells you corrosion. So that I know that is an ASTM standard, but we have a nice standard, by the way, that it's corrosion related, and the open circuit, which we want to follow the standard, but also we are using the corrosion aspect, which is kinetics. Kinetics means corrosion rate, not potential versus a reference, which sometimes works, sometimes not. So this is, again, the schematics, and of course that we do these schematics to illustrate that what I showed in the picture before, and this is the DC method. Oh, I don't know what I did, but I did something interesting. Okay, I did that. Okay. So, okay, I'm going to do it manually. So, and this is the DC and AC method. And you see, it's just about connecting the rebar with the working electrodes and a reference electrode, which you use for potential measurements. Also, the rebar can do another electrodes, can be the other electrode. So with just this setup, which we can use in the lab, we can use it in the field and measure corrosion rates, and not only potential, okay? So the characterization we are doing very aggressive. As I told you, it's very difficult to corrode concrete in the lab because it takes forever, especially if you control everything. So what we did is to design a testing method, which we call it the cyclic stage, or we call it the cyclic condition. What we do is do a cycling, like the, if you, I know that you will recall the splash zone. We are based on that. You know concrete structures that are immersed in the water, in the sea water. So you see that the most aggressive environment is not the sea water. You see just a biofilm, but the splash zone. That's what we did. Splash zone means that there are some spray, and that spray will just damage faster than either the atmospheric or the immersed. So that's what we did in the lab. We do in a fog chamber, in a spray. So we just make spray, and then we take out the spray. What we do in corrosion, remember the corrosion precursors? Water, oxygen, and chloride. The direct corrosion precursor is oxygen. Chloride. Okay, so we change the oxygen conditions, and we just change the oxygen content by putting water, taking out water. So that's the splash zone. And then in 84 years, sorry. That's not, well, it's not going to happen. In 84 days, so we have results instead of the standard that says it's 9 months. So in 9 months, the standard gives you results. Of course, that no one can wait for that amount. But 84 days, we have these results. Now we're improving in saying that we can do it in 30 days. And then the next presentation, I will just showing those results. In 30 days, we can tell you if it is good or bad in terms of any concrete. So for that, we just change the microcapsules. We have different concentrations. And also, we measure the properties of the of these concrete structures based on the microcapsules. Of course, the resistivity changes, and also the compressive strength changes also. But what is important is this. This is for everyone. Then they will be very familiar, as, again, with potential. The potential measurements according to the standard, the ASTM standard, is okay. Based on the standard, it says that control means that there is no microcapsules. So if we base on the standard, control says that is the lowest corrosion risk based on potential. And based on potential, if we add the microcapsules, then we are even destroying, we are not doing anything. We are doing even harm to this. But this is potential, this is feasibility. Again, what potential means is that the interaction between the electrolyte, the interface, and the rebar, and it's not corrosion rate. This is based on the standard, and this is likelihood of corrosion. So instead of using these parameters, we measure corrosion rate. The corrosion rate is a direct measurement of corrosion. And now we can say that control and the this percentage, the 2%, are almost equal, okay? So you see the difference of a potential versus the kinetics, so it can mislead you. So if I use only the standard potential, I wouldn't use even the microcapsules, they'll tell me, oh, the inhibitors that are releasing the microcapsule are detrimental. But if you open that river, you will see that nothing happens. So potential sometimes is mislead, but this is not the illustration. Now is the microcapsules are doing their job based on the fact that we have up to 2% and then what we are doing is two things. One, we either increase the concentration to make it to have less corrosion, or we modify the chemical. So, and this is after 84 days. So in 84 days, we can see that distinguish very well the differences of any chemical that we add in the microcapsules. So we have two things here that are very important. And again, that's the corrosion rate based on each one of the concentrations. You see that at 2%, that how the concentration rate is going down. So that's why it's important, again, to measure corrosion rate and no potentials. And in corrosion, we just we trust more corrosion rate rather than potential. So by saying this, the concentration microcapsule added had a significant effect of the physical properties of the concrete. But what is important, that also has a significant influence of corrosion. So based on that, the 2% was found having the best effect so far. And what we are proposing is to increase the percentage of the chemical in the microcapsules, to continue to prove that this technology is feasible to extend the stage one of this damage evolution in the concrete. And I think that